Hello and welcome to Webby Tutorials. In this video we are going to check out one of the best software for creating passport or ID card photos. Now let's go to the software. Here we can see the option to open the files. We are going to use these photos for demonstration. Let's select one and click open. The software has automatically detected the face. We can click these buttons to show or hide guidelines. Let's see the second step. Here we can adjust these red and yellow handles to resize and readjust the photo. Software will rotate the photo automatically by referencing the eyes, but you can readjust if you want to. Now let's see the third step. Here we have options for color adjustments, background editing, and photo retouch. The last step, we are given option to export or print the photo. Let's select the layouts we want to export. We can remove these red and blue lines from here. Now let's export and save the files in same folder. Saving is completed. We are asked what we want to do next. For now, let's click OK and close the tab. Now let's check the files we exported just now. Here we can see our ID photo ready for printing. For now, let's delete these outputs and check what other options we have. We have Russia International Passport selected as default. We can select any size from the options, or if you want country specific size, we can search by typing the name of the country. But now let's leave it as it is and let's see how we can create new layouts. Here we have our previous layouts. Let's create a new one. We have 35 by 45 mm here. Let's duplicate it. We can also drag a new one like this, and we can change the dimensions if we want to. Let's go for 20 by 30 mm. And another one for 30 by 40 mm. This is not going to work as we have cropped the photo in 35 by 45 mm dimension. For now, let me show you what happens by saving it with layout named as sample. As we can see here, these two are not showing up. Let's export it and see what happens. Here we can see those 20 by 30 and 30 by 40 mm dimensions did not export. Now let's see what we can do to make those dimensions show up. Here is 20 by 30 frame we dragged from here. And let's drag this one with four directional arrows named flexible frame. And change it to 20 by 30 mm. Let's keep the layout name sample 2 and click save as new. We can see that the bottom one with four directional arrow is showing up And if you have noticed, our previous layout has the arrows in all the photos as well. Now let's see the options to change paper size, text and QR code. Let's change the paper to 5x6 inches. Let's create some layouts. For 35x45mm, we can use photo frame option as we crop the photo in same dimension. But for other dimensions, we must use flexible frame. Let's create 55x55mm frames. So let's add a QR code and text. Let's save the template as sample 002. We can see that QR code and text did not appear. This happened because we didn't assign parameter for what to show. So let's edit the layout and make it so the QR code and text. For that, let's go to settings and then select layouts. Let's select the layout we want to edit and click edit button. We don't have space between these two, so let's fix this as well. QR, we click on the setting icon and let's put some text here and click OK. For text 2, let's click on setting. We can type or use keyword to show up. For now, let's use the file name and save the layout. It has not updated here, so let's close this tab. Now let's go to the compose layout option here. Here we can see our layout has updated with file name, QR code and gap between these photos. On the right side we can see recent photos we have worked with. We can mix them up for printing by dragging it to the frames in the templates like this. Let's export these mixed templates. Here are the outputs we exported. There are lots of options in this software which we have not covered in the video. If you want to try the software, you can get the download link in the description below. Let us know what you think about the software in the comment section. Also, let us know if you have any suggestions. You can check out our other videos related to ID card and photos here. Thank you for watching this video and we hope you have a good time. Bye bye.